relations. Social decision.
To you. Social perspective.
Yes and no. Back up a little bit. You know, they come in still out of collegiate system into a pro system. So now they get a chance to really develop, you know, in a pro-like system. We run the same system that the NFL run. Same system. So now it makes you more familiar with what you're doing as opposed to just coming right in, you know. Of course, we want the best of the best. And, then, you know, I have to also admit, because the NFL say you the best in that draft, that don't mean you necessarily the best in that draft, because it's thousands of universities across the country. There's no way in the world you can say this is the best player out of thousands of schools. That's who they deem to be the best. So, and I tell young men all the time, it's not that you're not good enough to play in the NFL. It's not enough room.
You're saying a minor professional football league. I mean, we know what the NFL is, but tell us what the MFL is.
Oh, absolutely. When you look at, everybody have a minor league system. Baseball has it, basketball. You know, you look at all the other professional leagues, soccer, but never minor professional football. So that's why I feel like it was a need for it. The minor football league is where the young men get an opportunity that you don't find outside of college or professional football. And therefore, you know, some guys come out of college not ready for the NFL ranks because the systems are different. As you know, college run college system, you know, 5-3, 5-2 defense. Well, in the NFL, everything's ran out of a pro set. 4-3 defense. You also have a 4-4 defense or 3-4 defense. What they do, and they run out offensively, they run a pro set. That's with two backs. Most college offenses are college system. And sometimes people have problems, young people have a problem with the understanding the terminology of it, and that's where you have what we call a gap in it, because the systems are different and it takes them longer to comprehend the system that they're running in the pro system.
Okay. So now when you say they have a problem, sometimes they have an issue with comprehending. What problems does them comprehending the two different systems causes for them?
Well, sometimes you take most college kids, players, some of them only go to these big schools and they're on a team, a college team for 4 to 5 years, most of them never play, you know. So really you're not getting the tools and technique you need to go to the next level, you know what I mean, if you get drafted, because you're not playing in the system. And remind you, that system is totally different from a pro system. You get some kids we call man-childs can step right in and play in the National Football League, they comprehend things a little faster. But some people take a while. That's just like in college. You have up to 4 years. You can get a freshman, you can redshirt him, he still has 4 years to play. Or if he come in, he got 4 years to learn the system. In the NFL, you have to come ready. You know, understand what I'm saying? You come ready, that's why you have guys drafted in the first round. These guys are drafted because they're expecting you to come right in and make an impact right off. And when you take guys in the later rounds, some of them, they give you a little time. But even then, some of those guys end up being cut 2 years after being on the taxi squad. Even then, you're not playing. You're practicing, but you don't actually get the opportunity to play in the system against other professional teams.
Okay, so you're teaching me a little bit here about the NFL today. I always thought if they got drafted and they were that number one pick, they immediately went out there and started to play. So now I'm understanding there's a system to how these gentlemen get to play in the NFL.
And didn't mean to cut you off. And even then, some even first round draft choices don't pan out well. As you can see, with a lot of them don't pan out. You know, you can name several. I can name several players. You know, Joe Washington. I mean, you know, he came in, and then you have. Certain players come in and either they're too small or they just can't grasp, because it's totally different. In college, you have a number of guys that's good. In the pros, everybody's good. You know what I mean?
So that is a true statement.
That's why you have starters. But you know, some guys just not ready and they need that extra time to season and learn technique and the tools of the trade.
So then that leads me to my next question. I'm understanding now how the draft is done in the NFL. Tell me the difference between how it's done in the MFL.
Well, it's really no difference. The difference is we are getting my opportunity to develop. You know, we're going to develop the player, you know.
Now they have somewhat of an alternative to come to or with the MFL and still play with the same momentum, the same techniques, the same wonderful coaching and style, but now they still have a chance for scouts to look at them again. Now that is a better understanding and explanation of it. I mean, it still may not be a heart-wrenching compensation for someone that was expecting to become an NFL pro player, but to understand that the reason you didn't get picked is not because you're not good, but there's just not enough room, does give a logical explanation to any person that can comprehend. So now let me ask you this question. When it comes to the MFL, where exactly are you located right now?
The NFL is 32 franchises across the country. We're as far as we're in Texas, we're in Kansas, we're in Utah, we're in Nevada, we're in North Carolina, South Carolina. You know, we're in, I don't know if I stated Texas, we're in Florida, we're in Alabama, Mississippi. I mean, the teams as far as we're in California, you know, we're in Ohio, you know, we have teams in Michigan, 32 franchises spread across the country.
Okay. And so I'm assuming you have two divisions just like the NFL also, correct?
Absolutely. We have the National Minor League Conference and we're the Minor League Conference. And it divided, you know, as you were asking me earlier, we had franchise in Washington, D.C., Baltimore. I put the Colts back up in Baltimore. Most people know the history of that, how they snuck out of Baltimore with the doors flying and stuff and went to Indianapolis, but we down in Virginia. You know, what we're trying to do is we want to keep most players home where the big schools are. I stated we in Tennessee, we down in Arkansas. I mean, we in cities that there are no professional franchises in terms of NFL, and we're in some cities where there are NFL franchises.
Okay. So with that market being said, where are you looking to go to next?
Well, we get ready to do big. We get ready to do some, bring out some exciting news later on. Right now, I'm not privileged to say, but I will say we want to make the trip to Africa. We want to put 16 NFL franchises in Africa. That's what we want to do, and that will really change the game in terms of, because I look at it all the time. We as people of color, the biggest consumers in America, we have nothing to show for it. And that narrative has to be changed with the MFL. And that's something we're doing, even with the incorporation of women owners and women general managers. These are some of the things that me as the owner and founder of the Minor Football League, these are the things that we're going to have that is mandated that the MFL do.
Okay. So let me ask a question. If a young man wanted to join your league, what does he need to do?
Well, you would do the same thing you would do in the NFL. We have combines coming up. You will try out. We don't want young men to think that they can leave high school and run here because you have to be 21. And I will always tell people, young people, go to school. And we understand that sometimes you might make college teams and sometimes you might not. But after you finish and you're at the age of 21, the MFL will be here. We're getting that opportunity to try out and make an MFL franchise.
At this moment, we're going to take a break and we'll be right back. Make sure you go fill your cup with a coffee or tea, that you have something to sip on.